Hey buddy! If you have more than one drive on your computer, then at some point you might have faced an issue where the drives aren't automatically mounted when you start the computer. In this video, I will show you the solution for this problem. We will learn what is an FSTab file, where does it live on a Linux file system, and how to add entries in the FSTab file. FS as in file system and tab as in table. An FSTab file is a file where the operating system stores where to mount a partition and how to mount it. For Linux, the FSTab file is stored in etc FSTab. All of the entries in the FSTab file will be automatically mounted on boot by the operating system. Now, we will try to mount a partition formatted with ext4 or 4th extended file system. Firstly, let's see which drives and partitions are available and where they are mounted. To do that, open a terminal and run the command LSBLK, which means list block devices. Here you will see the device or partition name, its size, whether it's read-only or not, its type, and where it's actually mounted. Note that drives don't have a mount point as they cannot be mounted directly. At least one partition is required in a drive to make it usable. A partition with the type of loop is a partition which does not physically exist. It is a virtual partition which is used like a container for holding some data. The drive with the type ROM in my case is a DVD drive, but this can sometimes be with the name of CD-ROM or HDC depending on your distribution of Linux. Now, we are interested in mounting the SDB1 partition, which is in the SDB drive. The first thing to do would be to get the drive's UUID or Universally Unique Identifier, which is just a string of text that is unique to every partition. To get that, let's run the command blkid, which stands for block identification. Running this command will give you UUIDs for all physical drives. Now, let's copy the UUID for SDB1, as that is the drive we need to get automatically mounted. As we now have the UUID for the drive that we want to add an entry in the FSTab file, let's open the FSTab file using a text editor. For this video, I will use Nano as it is the easiest and most people easily understand it. To edit the FSTab file, we need to run the command sudo nano /etc/fstab. We will use sudo because any other user except root will not be able to write to the file. So this is how the FSTab file looks. Note that editing this file with incorrect configuration may result in a broken system. Once we finish editing this file, I will show you how to verify if you have properly configured this file. Just to keep things organized, I will first create a comment with the label of the drive followed by the drive name in brackets. In the below line, type in UUID and an equal to symbol, then paste in the UUID that we copied before. Now press tab key once and then type the path where the drive should be automatically mounted on boot. In most Linux distributions, the drives are mounted in the /media directory. So I will write /media/data, which has the label of my drive. Again, press the tab key once and type the file system type, which in my case is ext4. Press tab key once again and type in the word defaults, as we need not pass any mount options. But if you know what you're doing, please feel free to alter this line according to your needs. Press the tab key again and type the number 0. Press the tab key once more and then type 0 once again. Once we have added the entry in the FSTab file, let's save it and exit the text editor. For Nano, I will press Ctrl O to write the file and then press Ctrl X to exit. Once we are out of the text editor, we need to create the path which we configured in the FSTab file. As I configured my drive to mount in /media/data, I will run the command sudo mkdir /media/data, which will create the directory, so the operating system can automatically mount this directory to the drive we specified in the FSTab file. Just to show you which partitions are where, I will again run the list block devices command. Now, to verify if your FSTab file was valid, run the command sudo mount-a, which will try to read the FSTab file and mount all the partitions specified in it. If you got no output, that means there were no errors. But still, just to confirm, run the list block devices command once again to see the changes. Now, as you can see, SDB1 is mounted on /media/data. Let's restart the system and see if it automatically mounts SDA1 to /media/data. To restart by a terminal command, type in sudo reboot now and press enter. Let's log in and open a terminal and then run the LSBLK devices command again. As you can see, the SDA1 partition is now automatically mounted to /media/data. Handling drives and partitions is a risky job. Make sure you double check the FSTab file before restarting the system. So that was it for this video. Please subscribe and hit the bell icon for more videos like this. This is Vasant Developer, signing off.